Let's now do a Python demo of a merged filter. And the example here is heartbeat detection in an ECG. So the heartbeat in an ECG, if this is here our axis here, then this looks like roughly like this. So that's a P wave, that's a Q, QRS complex, and that's a T wave here. And so we would like to detect that. So what we need to do is, so first we need to do some pre-filtering. And usually, especially very important is DC removal, because that messes up our threshold, and then 50 hertz removal. So similar to what I've shown before with the DFT, and then on the basis of this, we are creating our template. So something like that that we have, but what I just shown above there. So that's our template. And then we create our FIR coefficients by time reversing is it. Yeah, so we just take this one here. Let's say this is a bigger one, that's a smaller one that we getting now, than something like this out there, roughly. So that's a time reversed version of the one above. So then we filter it. Filter the ECG with the time reverse template. And then five, what we also usually just do, we square the result to improve signal to noise ratio. Okay, so let's do that. That's very, very simple. So let's have a look here. So what I've done is already I've created a clean ECG where I just removed all the noise from it. So therefore, if we have a look at this one here, so that's already pre-filtered, so there's no 50 hertz in it, and it's actually slightly too much high pass filtered, but we see it's DC free, and there's also no 50 hertz in it. So and therefore we can tick that off. DC is removed, 50 hertz is removed, and so we see we have a quite a nice and clean ECG already here. So that's sorted. So then we just need to create a template here. For the template, we need to create slice out one of these ECG actions there. Let's just bring it back here. So let's have a look here at the first action. So if we slice something between 500 and 1000, we should be able to generate basically here one generate our template. So 500 to 1000. So let's do that. So remember, so that's basically now template here. So the two. Okay, so let's generate our template. So we have it, we have this here, the signal in Y. So Y between just saying 500 to 1000. Let's have a look. Oops, just overwritten. Okay, so here we've got our template now running from 0 to 500. So it's a beautiful single heartbeat here, and so that's now sorted. So we have our template. That's a template. Let's just quickly show it again. So that's our template, what we just generated here. So template is sorted. So now we need to create our FRR coefficients by time reversing it. And so that with the splicing operations also very easy. So let's call this here then matched, you know, FIR. Let's call this FIR coefficients here. Template. And we just creating our reversed version of this. Plot FIR. So that's now our time reversed version of the previous one of the template here. So if I just plot this on top of that here, then we should see that this is time reversed. Indeed it is. Okay, so if I go back here to our writing here, so that was time reversing it. So that's here, time reversing the template. So we've done that. And so now we just filter the ECG with that. So filtering, we just use the inbuilt Python. And so that was FIR coefficient 1, comma, and then our signal was Y. Plot of that. Let's see how this looks like. So now we see here I'm getting already quite pronounced peaks here out of this detector, and that's the idea of the match filter, so that when the match is happening, that we're getting a very strong peak here, which is easy to detect. So now obviously we can make it even easier. So yeah, before I do this, so filter the ECG with the time reverse template. So we have done that. So we can also tick this here off. So that's done. And then the last bit is here, square the result to improve the signal to noise ratio. And so if we just do detector equals detector multiplied by detector to square it. And so if we plot that, so now we see, so the squaring operations, we are getting extremely high pulses here, up to 100. So therefore it's now very, very easy to put the threshold through here and to create our detection here. With that, we have a nice pronounced output here. Then this can be easily processed now just by thresholding and count and measuring the time between the heartbeat to get, for example, the heart rate out there.